If you need a new HDMI cable and or one that transmits full HDMI 2.1 speeds or 48 gigabits per second over long distances, you've come to the right place. As Ruipro was kind enough to send over two of their certified fiber HDMI 2.1 cables for review. That, as always, will not bias my opinion in any way. I will be covering 4 points. First, do they actually work, which I think is the most important? Second, what makes them special compared to the competition? Third, pricing. And last, frequently asked questions, myths, and use cases that I've seen to add some clarification. Timestamps to skip ahead if needed are down below. Let's get nerdy. First of all, do these guys work? Why, yes, I was able to get 4K 144Hz 10-bit with HDR without any issues. I tested on as many things as I could think of, which included two dedicated graphics cards, the 4090 and the 3060, two laptops, a 4K 120Hz HDR TV, 4K Blu-ray player, PS5, Apple TV, and eARC Atmos enabled soundbar, which I think should cover most people's use cases. They do report that these cables shouldn't be used with an HDMI splitter slash switcher. I'm not exactly sure why, maybe because most of those are HDMI 2.0, which would limit the capacity of these cables. I don't have one of those, so I wasn't able to test that personally, but throughout all of my testing, I ran into zero issues. Audio was crisp, without any pops or abnormalities, and any limitations I saw were from my source devices over the cable themselves. But don't take my word for it. Let's get over to actually showing them working.
Okay, real quick, just wanted to show. Got the HDMI there going into my soundbar with eARC up into my Vizio TV into that eARC port, which is then also plugged into my 4K Blu-ray player. I've got Black Adam playing right now, and if I go to info, you can see that it says Dolby Vision and Dolby Audio, and then it's also 2160p. And then if I go into here, move down to settings, and then picture, and then gaming, it says resolution 2160p, frame rate 24, HDR, Dolby Vision, variable refresh, no, and then Dolby Atmos DD Plus. So I've got everything working the way that it's supposed to be working. And then last but not least, if I go through here on my soundbar and I get all close so you can see, well, it says it, but I went a little too slow, so hold on. And there, Dolby Atmos is playing. All right, so this time around, I am connected to my 4K Apple TV, which is then going to my soundbar, which is then going to my TV. Right now, I've got Extraction 2 up on Netflix, and if we go around and we look, I've got Dolby Vision, Dolby Audio, and then if we go a little more into that, go down to settings, picture, calibrated dark CAD, and then there we've got resolution 2160p, frame rate is correct at 24Hz, HDR for Dolby Vision, and then Dolby Atmos for the sound. And then if I go over to my soundbar itself, we'll get nice and close here. And then if I go over here, you can see that it is correctly reading Dolby Atmos. So again, the cables, the 2.1 cables are good because, like I said, got one going to my soundbar, which then goes up and into the TV for the eARC. And then the other one goes from my TV and into the Apple 4K box. And we're on to the next test. I've got my 4090 connected to the HDMI cable that goes into my TV. And then we are in NVIDIA control panel. Right there, you can see that it is a normal G-Sync is working. Moving over to that, we've got 120Hz. We've got all the same options that we had on the previous thing. And then if I go here, we have use HDR. It is supported for streaming and for the just normal HDR. And then, I don't know what else to show you. So now we'll actually go to my 4K 144Hz HDR monitor instead. And we're back. So again, 4090 to 4K 144Hz screen with HDR. And we've got G-Sync that is on. If I go over to change resolution, we've got the full 144Hz. We've got the 10-bit RGB 4K. And then if I go over here, we've got that 10-bit. If I go to display, I can go to HDR if I want to. I can turn it on. And then we've got supported. Then we're good to go there. Okay, for the final test, back on the laptop. This time I've got the HDMI going into my 4K 144Hz monitor. Since we're already in this screen, we may as well just stick here. If I go over, we've got the 4K. If I go to the advanced display, got the 144Hz. We've got the 10 bits. If I move over here and go into the HDR, I can not flick that on because, again, I don't have it plugged into battery, but I've shown on multiple of the other things that it would work just fine. Also tried on my 3060 over there that it works just fine as well, but I won't show you that one again because I feel at this point we're kind of beating a dead horse of obviously this cable is working just the way that it should.
Moving on to number two, looking closer at these, it comes with a nice box which provides most of the information you need on the product, along with a certification holographic that you can scan to prove that this isn't a fake HDMI, as confirmed on HDMI.org. True to HDMI 2.1 spec, they also have provided the certification label on the cable itself, which is really nice because in case you're like me and have a ton of HDMI cables, if you're looking for a specific one, you can easily look for that and be like, bam, I know this one will work for me. With this certification, you know that you are getting full HDMI 2.1 specs. If you don't know all of those features, you can either go to HDMI.org and do some research yourself, or check out my dedicated HDMI 2.1 video listed in the description down below. Since these are fiber optic, they have hybrid insides, where the video transfers via the light and then the audio via the typical copper, or at least I believe that's true. Whereas with typical HDMI cables, they just have a copper wiring, and due to that, it limits how far a signal can effectively go. The cables they sent over are 7.6 meters or 25 feet and 10 meters or 33 feet, and both hit full spec without any issues on a multitude of devices, as previously discussed. These distances are impossible with traditional HDMI cables, or I'm getting a little verbose with my language there. Okay, so a normal copper cable may be able to go that far. I highly doubt it, which is the whole purpose of fiber cables in the first place, is to go long distances. As typical copper cables usually max out at around 5 meters or 16 feet, as we are at the point with HDMI 2.1b that pushing 48 gigabytes per second long distances is freaking hardcore and super difficult with a traditional copper cable, as you need to increase the gauge or thickness of the cable to try and push that signal effectively to the other end. The longer the cable gets, the more prone it is to interference, abnormalities in the cable manufacturing process, which can then degrade the signal and prevent it from adequately reaching the other side. This bulkiness also makes maneuverability difficult, which is why these fiber cables are so freaking awesome. As the fiber is less prone to interference, travels a lot faster, and therefore allows it to go longer distances without issues while maintaining smaller gauges, increasing their maneuverability. This cable sleeving is absolutely excellent. It is very malleable, as you can kind of see, and with a metallic braid inside and a rubber outside, which provides good shielding and durability. It is rated to be used inside of walls safely. However, since it uses lights, if you kink the cable, you can run into issues as light can't passively make a crazy turn, so avoiding severe bends is definitely advised. With it being fiber, it also requires the cable to be directional, making it so there is a dedicated source side and a dedicated display side, which can be a pain if you aren't paying attention during initial setup, which I've gotten wrong enough times that now I always make sure to look before I actually start to run the cable. The enclosures themselves feel like metal, but I don't know if they actually are or not. I think it's actually maybe just, I don't know, maybe high quality plastic. Regardless, it feels absolutely great and are super solid. You also have reinforcement on the back tip here, and it comes with gold tips, which provides better longevity for plugging and unplugging, and also better protects against generalized wear and corrosion. However, the most important part is not these gold tips, but the connectors inside, which are also gold. This is important as gold is soft, which makes it easier to compress and form around the connectors to fill those small voids, increasing the chance of the cable making full spec and full speeds while also being highly corrosive resistant, which are all the things that we want from a premium HDMI cable. So from my perspective, this cable checks all the boxes. The only negatives that I can really think of is this color doesn't necessarily fit my color scheme that I've got going on, which tends to be very dark, kind of like my soul. But also, these are super expensive. And really, that's it. Which on a review where somebody sent me a product, kind of makes me sound like a shill, which I don't like, but honestly, they just nailed everything. They knocked this guy out of the park that I really can't think of other negatives. Which brings us to the third point, pricing. This isn't a cheap cable by any means, and it definitely comes in at the higher price of the spectrum, even when comparing apples to apples, which would include fiber, certification, and the same distances. As you're paying more for higher quality components, such as the gold tips, the gold connectors, the metal enclosure, the rubber wire, the fiber that's inside, the actual certification, all of the things, along with the longer distance. And when I was looking at the competition, it did appear to have better build quality than the rest of the competition, but was it enough to justify the difference? That I'm not quite sure about. There could also be some minor things that I missed when I was doing a quick comparison, such as these being rated to be able to be used in walls, where there's other cables that aren't because they can catch fire, and then you lose your whole home because you bought a cheap HDMI cable. Okay, I went a little crazy there. That's probably not going to happen, but you get what I'm saying. As I didn't spend a whole lot of time researching A to B everything and getting everything perfect for this part of the video. Additionally, non-certified, slightly worse internal cables are also going to be a lot less expensive, and you can get the same results assuming you don't need distance and they work correctly. And even if they do have the same distances and they work, then it works and you saved yourself a bunch of money. I'll explain that a little bit more on the next point. There are also a ton of similar length cables that claim to give full speeds at a lot less, but I am skeptical of them, and if you look at the reviews, a lot of people have issues with them when trying to get full 48 gigabit speeds, as it looked like most of the people that had no issues were using older devices that were using the 18 gigabits per second standard, which is a lot easier to transmit over longer distances than 48 gigabits. But regardless, these continue to be some of the most expensive cables that I saw, but you know, they work, and sometimes that peace of mind is worth paying for. But of course, that comes down to you to decide. They do come with a 5-year warranty, whereas the competition tended to come in with mostly 2 to 3 year warranties and sometimes 5. I would say that the cheap cables tended to be 1 to 3 years, and then the more expensive cables were almost all 5 years. At time of recording this review, the 7.6 meter/25 feet was $114.99, but with their 20% off coupon, that comes to $91.99, and for the 10 meter/33 feet, it is $124.99 or $99.99 with 20% off. Of course, that is in US dollars. That pricing may change depending on where you're located geographically on the planet. Fourth and last, I'm going to be going over some frequent questions / myths / use cases that I see to just kind of add some clarification. One, no, this cable will not make your picture look better, as HDMI is digital, which means to a certain extent, it either works or it doesn't. There are some caveats with this, of which I recommend you check out my dedicated HDMI 2.1 video where I explain a bit further, as I don't have time in this video to cover that. Two, with short distances, HDMI.org reports typically under 5-ish meters or 16.4 feet to be kind of the max length. Normal copper HDMI cables are fine to use, but once you start to go longer distances, the chances of having issues increases. As mentioned, the longer the distance, the more you have to push that electricity / conductivity, and if there are any errors in the copper / materials and or the external interference from wireless devices, it further degrades that signal to the point where it may not get fully from point A to point B. But if it works, it works. With fiber cables, you are just reducing the likelihood of having those issues, as the tech is a bit more advanced and resistant to material errors and interference. Moving on to number four, you don't need a certified cable, but I do recommend it, as it ensures that you are going to get a cable that works, assuming you get a correctly working product, as everything always has a failure rate, as nothing is more frustrating than wasting a bunch of time trying to troubleshoot an issue only to find out it was your stupid cable that you got inside the box of your product that was just terrible. If you're interested in what some of those issues can be, again, HDMI 2.1 dedicated video might be for you. The HDMI 2.1 spec is more regarding the ports on the input and output device of the cable itself over the actual cable, as you need them both to have 2.1 ports along with a good enough cable to transmit the data fully. As you can have a cable from ages ago that meets modern standards. For example, I have a monster HDMI cable, not like monster as in like, this thing is awesome, or arg, I'm going to eat you, but more like that's the name of the company. And it's from 2013, and it works just fine, despite HDMI 2.1 becoming a thing in 2017. As again, the cables don't really change since then, it's the ports themselves on the device. As the only differences regarding the cable itself are tighter tolerances, better build quality, and occasionally better components, which helps increase the chance of getting that signal from point A to point B. As 90% of HDMI cable marketing is fluff. So if the device you are using is working just fine, then you don't need to upgrade. And if you upgrade to a new device and everything is working just fine, once again, you don't need to get a new cable. However, if you are running into issues or needing longer distances, make sure to check the cable first before you try to troubleshoot the actual device itself. And in that case, if you are running into issues, going fiber is definitely recommended. And again, I really enjoy these. And if you've got the money to spend, these would be an excellent choice. Last, HDMI has a silly naming scheme, as HDMI 2.0 or premium high-speed cables are one and the same, and the old standard that most devices have. Whereas the recently, in the last couple of years, HDMI 2.1 or ultra high-speed cable have become one and the new spec that supports 48 gigabits per second. And those cables can say some or all of those terms, such as ultra high-speed cable, HDMI 2.1, 48 gigahertz, 8K, a whole bunch of other stuff. So it just makes it a little hard to shop for. In conclusion, this is a fantastic cable that comes with all of the bells and whistles. And I really can't find any faults outside of maybe this color and the price. I will be using it a ton in my own personal life, as this is one of the best cables I've ever had. And I do highly recommend it if you can stomach the price. Questions, comments, concerns, the comment section's got you, where I will reply back. Otherwise, like this video if you enjoyed it, dislike it if you hated it, and of course, if you're interested in seeing more content like this, consider subscribing. Otherwise, I will see you and your beautiful face on the next one. God bless, and peace out.